that giant sticky white box in the center of the boat that the handsome gentleman is pointing to. And white, another white box in the back of the boat and a closet at the back of the boat as well also has adult-sized white jackets. Also at the back of the boat, we have four restrooms, or heads as they call them, on boats. And just in case you're just joining us, we do have a full bar on board. I love you locals, welcome aboard. Now, to your left we have, well, in the distance, you actually can walk out there to your left with your American flag flying. That controls the level of the lake compared to the level of the river. And how this river works, how the Chicago River works. Well, it hooks up with Lake Michigan behind us, and then it flows about a mile down this way. This is the main bridge that we're going to head into. The main bridge flows for about a mile before turning into a Y shape called Wolf Point. That is where the main bridge turns into the North Branch and the South Branch. So on this tour, we're heading out west first until we get to Wolf Point. We'll spend a little bit of time up on this North Branch, and then we'll turn around, and then we'll go down the South Branch too, and then turn around, and then come back here. Now, where Lake Michigan hooks up with the Chicago River, that's the reason why Native Americans have been in this area long before this was ever a big city. The Illini, the Miami, and the Potawatomi are those groups. They didn't tend to live in what we're looking at right now, downtown Chicago now, because this was all swamp, where the Chicago River emptied into Lake Michigan, so the swampy river delta. And apparently, because wild onions grew everywhere here, lovely, the Potawatomi called those onions Chicagua. Yeah, that's our namesake, onions. Yeah, that's what this means. Well, now, the world built by a woman led architect for her. And those are real balconies, those strange balconies on it. They're set to correspond to specific views that you can get from inside the building. So it's kind of site-specific design. This is 1,136 feet tall. When it was built, it was the tallest marble clad building in the world. It's not covered in marble anymore. It used to be covered in this beautiful Italian marble, Carrara marble, the same marble that Michelangelo used to create sculptures like David. But it didn't stand up to our extremes of weather in Chicago. Coming off the building at alarming rates, so they had to pull it all off and resurface it and rent it. And that cost between $60 and $80 million. But the center of it, close to us, that is a water cannon. That shoots an arc of water across the entire river. Every hour on the hour until midnight. Except for 3 and 4. So nobody will be able to see it. Look about Chicago weather that I'll repeat to you right now. I know it's kind of a cliche to say about other places too. If you don't like the weather in Chicago, wait 5 minutes. Because the expressway bridge we passed. At 3 and 4, rush hour is just starting, and what half p.m. and 6 p.m. Why? It's already gridlocked on the bridge and it doesn't matter anymore. It's true. Urban planning. Now, to your right, a big hotel, the Sheridan Hotel. I want you to notice on this building the green glass windows. Compare that color of the windows to the color of the river. Pretty much exactly the same. That's on purpose. That's more site-specific design. Again, the Sheridan Hotel is also known for being one of three hotels in the city with bulletproof glass in the presidential suite. Presidents have stayed in there. Presidents Carter, Clinton, and Obama. You might be wondering, wait a minute, critical thinking, everybody. The president, when he comes to Chicago, doesn't go home. He stays in hotels because when presidents visit, traffic turns into a nightmare. It's a courtesy to the city. The Obamas moved into the White House from Chicago. Michelle Obama was born and raised in Chicago. Large black skyscrapers. These glass skyscrapers, 389 feet tall. That building is called the Trump Tower, can you tell? Just in case you didn't notice. Yeah. The building is 5 years old, but the sign is from this summer. It's new. According to all of the editorials about it, everybody hates it. They say it's too, like, in your face, basically. That's all there is to it. It's a big glass box. Popular in the 60s. Now, up ahead of us, the round skyscrapers are built by Bertrand Goldberg. One time the student of Mies van der Rohe, student teacher, very different here. This is Marina City from 1967. In Chicago, we have an adorable nickname for these, and accurate. We call them the corncob towers. These are students, they're apartments. There's a great quote from Bertrand Goldberg that explains why he built like that. Quote, we are kind of work against that. And it works, people have always loved the corncob towers, even though their foreheads are really clear, they're triangles. It's like living in a pie slice. Oh, now today, it is asymmetrical. It's uneven on either side of the tower. Count the windows out on the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, face the windows. On the left, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's shorter up there, because the building is older. Amazing. The building also has a very horizontal feel to it. Very flat feeling building. Lines to graph. That's the motif, that's the local referring to associated with any Western Wolf Chicago. Pass this building. And this style is called Art Deco. I'll explain Art Deco to you. It has four major elements. First of all, stone on the outside. Also setbacks at the top, some kind of staircase effect at the top. It's very good for Art Deco. Geometry and its design with the diamonds at the base and the top of the building that I'll show you on the north branch. Ahead of us, the tall white building with the curving facade. That is Rickman from 2002. It's a postmodernist building. It's site-specific. It's contextualist. The curving facade is like, and you'll see that again too. This makes the building look cool, but it also optimizes views out east. All the apartment spaces are the back end of the hallway. And look, I'll tell you exactly what's coming in there later. But first I want to show you these kind of sort of neat in here from the Union Stockyards. And if you look at the balconies, this to your left, the River Cottages. The River Cottages, four townhomes. You wouldn't be allowed to go back there today. Wouldn't be allowed. It's not Dakota anymore. Instead, be encouraged to go like that, to your left. The Kinsey Park townhomes. These are new construction from the 2000s. Hazards, of course. Everything right into the river. And it was an everyday thing. People have written about it a lot. You can see people write about it all the time. That it was just a normal reality on the river to see, like, decomposing animal parts. Carcasses. So again, not only is it disgusting, it is a health hazard to have something like this in a river. And it was especially a health hazard because all this biohazardous pollution was flowing out the river into our drinking from the city water. If you can't call yourself a modern city, you're dying from drinking the tap water. So we had to fix this. 25 years ago, because look at the platform to your right. Low clearance. This one wouldn't make it through. This is pretty low rope. So to keep it up out of convenience. And people actually like how this looks so much. They don't want it to get pulled down. It's been turned into a landmark structure. That means it's protected from being torn down. It's here to stay. And to be not used. Basically, it's turned into a sculpture. That was a word. And up ahead of us, you sure left the construction site. Will be Wolf Point Town. Will be residential one of the offices. And they're going to be treated to an amazing view with these towers that we're taking away from this part of the tour. Over to your left, you'll see it in. Once you get on these cranes here, these mushrooms. That's through the whole river. It's so funny. It's a perfect example of how we just take this. We just call this river Pizza Ditch. We really believe it. We believe that this river was worthless. And off there to the left there. And I'll point out that to your right, this is also new development. This structure is 4.0. It will look completely different over the next few years. You'll just have to take our tour down. Amtrak Railroad underneath this building. And you can use plenty of dogs for the train tracks. This is something we're about to see a lot of. The train tracks have been running down the south branch of the river for a very long time, 200 years ago. But developers want to put steps that we're on. Like they're doing right here. Just starting here this summer. This stop will be residential highways. And so if I'm a developer, what's the process here? I see this spot and I think, well, there are train tracks there, but look at all that space. I want to put a skyscraper there and make money less than with the people. So I talk to Amtrak. I can't find the way. They don't want to put their train tracks, it's not enough. The Boeing building, the Boeing Aerospace Engineering Corporate Headquarters is right here. Right here in Chicago. This skyscraper won an award for its air rights construction. Because not only is it built on top of train tracks, but this building had an extra challenge that they found a solution to. How are you going to support a building from below when you've got no room for a platform? There was no room right here to your right. Now look away because the sun's coming. Well, they knocked that office space, but they couldn't support it from below. The solution is clear. They suspended it from above. It hangs at the top that holds it. It's a truss. That's called a truss. A truss looks kind of like a bridge. So not only is that holding the bridge out, it's also tip of the hat to our bridges on the river. Perfect. Perfect postmodernist example of contextualism. Moving on to your right, this is the first time we did it. This is on top of train tracks too. We've been doing it since then. 1930, just amazing. Originally this building was called the Daily News Building. When it was built, it was the operations headquarter for the Chicago Daily News. The hole in the wall shows us the perfect window in on air rights construction. As far as those lights go, you can see the grid work of pylons. And you can hear if you can't see the trains. I see the trains, they're up ahead of us. And here comes one right now. Ha ha! That's never happened before. That's perfect. The Metro Cross Suburban Train Line. That's great. built by the same architecture firm, Skidmore, Owings, and Merrill. So same thought process, but different style. So this is the 60s skyscraper.
All the 70s look.